want you to note this, that do not walk in fear. Do not allow fear to be activated in you. How many know it'll come?
Yes.
But don't activate it. Because when fear, with fear, fear activates the move of Satan in your situation and in your circumstance. So whenever you, when you take in that fear, because it will come, but don't give it no activity. Don't give it no place, no thought. You rebuke it, because when you do, when you give it space, when you give fear space, you have invited the devil into your situation, your circumstance, and he will wreak havoc. And then, but faith brings God on the scene.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Faith brings him on the scene, because God honors faith.
Yes.
And nothing, anything that's not done in faith, he doesn't honor anyway. So faith, when you say, God, I believe you, he just steps right in. Hallelujah. Your faith in God activates him in your situation. And remember, you are not your circumstance.
Amen.
What did I say?
You are not your circumstance.
Hey, make it personal.
I am not my circumstance.
Listen, I am what I believe.
I am what I believe.
Say it, I am what I believe. I am not my circumstance. I am not my situation. Hallelujah. I am what I believe. And I believe God.
Hallelujah.
His word is forever settled in heaven. He watches over it to perform it. Before one shot or twin ten will fail, God said, I'll call time out. He said, he said, heaven and earth will pass away before one jot or tittle of my word fail. Woo! Glory to God. Come on, let's access that today. I want to talk to you about how the number 17 represents complete, say complete.
Complete.
And total.
And total.
Victory.
Victory.
Number 17. And so here we are on the third day of marching to complete and total victory.
All right.
All of 17. Because we can access what God is for. You can hold yourself in it. Clothe your mind in it and just walk in it. Hallelujah, because it is so. In the Bible, 17 symbolizes overcoming the enemy and complete victory. God overcame the sins of rebellion when he flooded the earth through rain on the 17th of the second month, on the second Hebrew month. That's documented. Noah's ark and its eight passengers rested on the mountain of Ararat on the 17th day of the seventh month, right in the middle of what became the Feast of the Tabernacles.
My God.
Amen.
These are facts. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Praise our God. Jesus Christ gained complete victory over death and the grave when God resurrected Jesus from the grave. And in the book of 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, listen to this. The 17th mention of the word love comes when Paul states that it is the greatest gift of all. In 2 Corinthians 13:13. God's unending love is John 3:16. What's that? Y'all know what that is. What is it?
God's love.
He so loves. He so loved. And let me tell you what. And the Lord gave you a revelation on that. On so love. He just didn't say that God loved the world.
So love.
He said, so love. I said, Lord, what does that mean? So love. He said, intentionally.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When he said, I so love you, I intentionally gave you my son.
Thank you.
I had a plan from the beginning.
Hallelujah.
I know he wasn't going to get it right. I know all the stuff was going to happen. So I so love you enough to give you my only beloved. Hallelujah. When you so love something, you do something about it. You get busy, you handle the situation. Even if it's to your own hurt, if you so love, you handle it. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He so loved us, he so loved us, he so loved us. Hallelujah.
35, the Apostle Paul says, what? I want y'all to get this. What? Said what?
What?
He said, what shall separate us from the love of Christ? Hallelujah. He asked seven things. He said, so tribulation, that's a what? He said, persecution, that's a what? Can't get around. Hallelujah. He said, and because we need persecution, you all don't want to, but we need it.
Yeah.
He said, distresses, that's a what?
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. He said, what's wrong with you? I'm in the distress. Hallelujah. He said, nakedness, that's a what?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Famine, that's a what?
Hallelujah.
The sword, or any danger, that's a what?
Amen.
Then he tells us 10 things that cannot. Okay, we dealt with the what. Now look at what came. He said, 10 things that cannot get between our God and us, which are. Okay, so we're dealing with what things can happen. And now we're going to deal with who things can happen. Can't get between us. Hallelujah. He said, can life, can death, principalities, can powers, angels, things present. I'm looking at right now some things that if they come to pass, God have to step in between.
That's right.
And what you have to say is, God, you are the who to any what.
Yes.
My God.
You are the who to any what.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's my who. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let me tell you.
Hallelujah.
He says, he gives us strength. There's nothing that can come against us that God cannot handle.
Amen.
No height or anything created. And when you add up the seven what's and the 10, hallelujah, you got 17 things that represent God stepping in between.
Hallelujah.
Don't get scared because trouble comes.
That's right.
We got a who.
Yes,
we do. Hallelujah. don't give up when you're persecuted and misunderstood and look like everything that you trusted is turned against you. We got a who. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Who can separate me? What can separate me? Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Now I got happy. Thank you. Hallelujah. A saint's perfect and eternal standing with God through Christ Jesus.
My God.
All this year, you start, you just say, I'm standing with the great God. Ain't nothing to nothing.
Hallelujah.
Nothing. Turn you around. Nothing. It caused me to give up.
There you go.
I won't give up.
No.
Hallelujah. Woo. And the disciples said, Jesus said, will y'all go too? They said, where are we going?
That's right.
You're the one that have eternal life.
We're
not going nowhere. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Came over, and the old saint sung a song, came over here to stay, Lord.
Till I die.
I came over here to stay, Lord.
Till I die.
That's it. Thank you, Jesus. Uh-huh. And as we study and move forward, let this year be a mark in your spiritual self. Let it be a mark in your spiritual self. Listen, ask God. These are some things I want you to look at in your own life this year. Ask God for a greater insight.
Yes.
Don't you know he gives us revelation to his word?
Yes, he does.
It's just like he fully shaded up.
Yes.
I remember when I first got started, in ministry, I'm a good researcher. Oh, honey, I could research it down to the last word. Had it so pretty, and I had a wonderful message that I had gotten together. And I said, you hear what I'm saying now? A wonderful message that I had gotten together. And I said to the Lord, I said, ooh, this is a And I said, ooh, this is really wonderful. And what came to me was, what you have there, this is how it came to me, what you have there will enlighten the mind. I got so excited because right away my mind went to the first chapter of Ephesians, that 17th verse, that the eyes of the understanding might be enlightened. I said, ooh, thank the Lord for the enlightened mind. And he let me have that for a minute. Then this one came to me. You know, you can read a book and get your mind enlightened. So, oh, then I felt a little bad right then. He let me have that for a minute. Then he came back to me with this. And I live in it. He said, but if you will allow me to give you the revelation, I will deliver the soul.
Hallelujah.
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 That's when I stepped out of that mind enlightening situation. Oh, and all that intellectual stuff.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I'm educated. Hallelujah. Got a master's degree plus some. But honey, that ain't nothing. You know what God spoke to me? Hallelujah. He gave me this.
Hallelujah.
I was all excited. I had witnessed to this doctor, and his wife was a nurse, and I'm on my way home. Hallelujah. And I was excited. I said, ooh, God, he's a doctor, and she's a nurse. Mm-hmm. Just think of what they can do for you in the kingdom. And he let me have it for a minute. He always just let me have it. Hallelujah. Then he came back and talked to me. He said, I don't need your diplomas, and I don't need your degrees. He said, all I need is a willing mind.
Hallelujah.
He said, I took a donkey that everybody know can talk, and I made him talk and save the life of my brother. He said, I took a rooster and made him crow to verify my word. He said, all I need is a willing mind. He said, I took 2 men that the people could see was ignorant and unlearned, and knew that one man, and he preached and brought forth 3,000 souls on one day. He said, all I need is a willing mind. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! I pray to him every day, God, break down my will. I give my will to you. If you take my willing mind, I'll say what you say. I'll do what you say. I'll go where you go.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Let's stand.